Hello students, welcome to the class. Today in this session now we are going to begin with the new chapter, that is globe and maps. By looking at the name of the chapter itself, we'll come to know that what we are studying. So here purely we are going to study about globe, uses of these globes, and then about the maps, types of maps, and how it is used for us. Okay, let us start our study, that is introduction. Study of the globe and map as good teaching learning aids for the better understanding of geography. To understand geography in a very well manner or in a very better way, these globes and maps, they are going to help us as a teaching aid. The meaning and uses of globes here. Now in this lesson we are going to study about what is the meaning of the globe and how we are going to use it. The meaning, types and uses of maps are also studied. Then we are going to study the important geographical symbols required for the preparation of maps, and also we are going to study about map reading. So now let us first study about globe. Okay, so you have already studied about the shape and size of the earth. Now what we are going to study is the earth is a geoid in shape and is represented by a globe. Geoid in shape means we can see that earth, it is not flat and it is a solid shape, right? Now we are going to represent earth in this form, that is in a very solid figure. This helps us to know about or a rough picture of how the earth is all about. And this system is called as what? It is called as globe. And what they have given? The photographs taken of the earth from the satellites give a real shape of the earth. See, just if we look, we are going to see only the one part of the earth. But if we take the pictures of earth from the satellite, we are going to get the earth looks like this. Okay. Then what they have given, but we can see only one side of the earth. The globe, which is the model of the earth, can give us the view of the other side also, since we rotate the globe. What has happened here is, if we take a picture, we can only see from the one side of the globe, one side of the earth, right? But if we are looking it in the form of a globe, we can rotate this globe and see all the parts of the earth. So globe, it is one of the most useful teaching aid for the better understanding of this geographical features of the earth. Now let us know about the features of a globe. What we are going to study? We are going to study about the features of a globe. Features of a globe. The globe is a miniature model of the earth. Miniature model of the earth, in a sense we can say earth, it is a minimized model, a small model of earth. So this globe, it is a small model of earth. It is a true representation of the earth's spherical shape and not flat as seen on the map. See, it is a very perfect spherical shape of the earth, and as maps, it is not flattened. Besides, it gives us information about many features of the earth. This simple globe, it is going to indicate us many other features of the earth. It is a simple teaching learning aid. As I said earlier, this globe, it is the most simple learning as well as teaching aid. It can be kept on the table and rotated. See what we have done? We have already kept this globe on the table and we can rotate it very easily. It helps us to learn about different geographical concepts. This globe, it helps us to study different geographical concepts. Now let us study about the uses of globe. Okay, now let us know about the uses of globe. So uses of globes. The globe is useful to know the shape of the earth. See, as I have showed you already, the globe, it is very much useful to know us how the earth is, what is the shape of the earth. It helps us to understand the position, shape and size of the continents, oceans and seas. Also, globe, it is going to help us to understand the position of any continent, or what is the shape of the continent, then we are going to know about the oceans and also about the seas. The lines of latitude and longitudes on the globe help us to locate places and political boundaries. Those latitudes and longitudes on the globe, what they are going to do? They are going to help us to understand or to locate the places as well as the political boundaries. Next, a good globe helps us to understand the inclination of the axis. Inclination of the axis means to what extent, or we are going to know about the degree of slopes with the help of this globe. Movements of the earth can be understood, that is rotation and revolution, and also their effects can be understood with the help of the globe. Means effects in the sense when we are going to get a day and night and also the seasons. It gives general information about the geographical features such as mountains, plateaus, plains, deserts, islands, rivers, etc. With the different symbols, we can denote these mountains, plateaus, plains, deserts, rivers, etc. on the globe. So, this is all about the uses of the globe. Now, next, let us study about maps. So, we finished studying about globe. Now, let us study what are maps. Okay. So, the globe can give us only very general information about the earth. So what was the globe doing? It was providing us, of course, information, but it was purely a general information given on the globe. Maps are very essential to get detailed information of a place, state or a country, and also about other geographical features. So map, that is very important. For what purpose? To get the detailed information about a place, state or a country, and also about other geographical features. A diagrammatic representation of the whole earth on a part or a part of it on a flat surface according to scale is called a map. So what is a map actually? A diagrammatic representation of whole earth or a part of it on what? On a flat surface according to the scale, that is called as a map. See, we can see here the world map, which is of course a diagrammatical representation, or it is going to represent as the whole earth or a part of it. See, on this flat paper, this map is the world map. With the help of map, what all we can see? See, the science and art of map making is known as cartography. This art of making the graph, it is called as cartography. And then the collection of various types of maps. So this is what we call as map of very flat surface. How we are going to represent? This is the entire earth we are representing. You can see the different continents present on the earth. We can see the oceans and entirely whatever we used to see on the globe, it was a solid figure. The same thing can be here seen in the map. Okay, this is what we call as a map. Now, let us see. We studied about the globe. We studied about map. Now, let us know that the collection of various types of maps bound as a book is known as an atlas. I have showed you one single map. Like that, the collection of maps in a book, what it is called? It is called as atlas, or we can say that it is known as atlas. Okay. Now, let us study about the types of the maps. Types of maps. Okay. On the basis of scale and purpose, maps can be classified as follows. Depending upon the scales or depending upon the purpose what we are using, we can classify the maps. So the first one is maps based on scale. Okay. Maps based on scale. Okay. There are two types of maps based on scale. So totally how many maps? Two types of maps are there based on scale. Among that, the first one is large scale map. Large scale maps. These maps represent small areas. These large scale maps, what they are going to do? They are going to represent very small areas. They can be divided into cadastral maps and topographical maps. See, these large scale maps can be further divided into cadastral maps and topographical maps. Cadastral maps means they show real places, bounds of the country and all. Whereas these tropical maps, they are going to represent the shapes and characteristics of the earth's surface. They are called as topographical maps. Cadastral maps show individual property. What happens? These cadastral maps, they are going to show individual's property. Whereas the tropical maps, they show detailed surface features. See, we can see this is how the large scale maps look like. Next, we are going to see about small scale maps. They represent large areas, world, continents and countries. These large scale maps, they represent small scale maps, they represent large areas, like they are going to represent worlds, continents or countries. They are of two types. Again, these small scale maps are of two types. Where are they? Which are they? Wall maps and atlas maps. Wall maps, as I showed, putting it on the wall. Atlas maps in the sense what? A book of maps which will be like this, and a variety of maps will be present in that book. It is called as atlas maps. Wall maps are larger in size than the atlas. Of course, what happens? Wall maps, they are larger in size when compared to that of the atlas maps. They are used as teaching aids in the classroom. They can show general and important features such as political divisions, physical features, etc. These maps, they are going to show features such as political divisions, physical features, etc. The maps in the atlas are smaller in size, but they also give us information. The maps in the atlas are smaller in size, but they are also going to give us the same information as that of the wall maps. Next, we are going to study, first one was map based on scale. The second one is maps based on purpose. What it is? Maps based on purpose. They are also known as thematic maps. Those maps which we are using according to the purposes, they are also called as thematic maps. They can be classified as follows. These maps based on purpose or thematic maps are the further classified. Among them, the first one is physical maps. Physical maps. These maps show the political boundaries between states, countries and continents and their location, area, etc. Political maps, what they are going to show? They are going to show the political boundaries between the two states or between the countries and the continents, as well as their location and area. So physical maps, right? These maps represent the physical features. These physical maps, they are going to represent physical features such as mountains, plateaus, plains, rivers, etc. Next comes political maps. These political maps, they are going to show political boundaries of what? Political boundaries of any state, between two states or between two countries or continents. And also they are going to show their locations and area, etc. Next comes distribution maps. Next one is distribution maps. These maps are used to show the distribution of definite features. Particular features are shown in this distribution maps, such as land use, temperature, rainfall, population, soils, natural vegetations, crops, minerals, industries, railways, roads, waterways, etc. We can see that in these distribution maps. Next, we are going to see what are the components of maps. Okay, we studied the types of maps. Now we shall study what are the components of a map. What are the requirements? The basic component of a good map are title. As soon as we see any map, it's difficult for us to identify, right? That is why the most basic thing required for the map is to know the title of the map. Like for example, if they have given the map of India, it should have written in below that it is the India map, like that. Okay, the first one is, that is title, scale, latitudes and longitudes, direction and index. Among that, the first one is title. Every map must have a suitable title which tells us the content of the map. Whatever the map is representing, whatever is its contents, it should have a title. For example, it should have like this: India, its physical features, or India political. Physical features or the same India map which is political, India political, etc. This is the title of the map. Next comes the scale. A scale is a ratio between the distance on the map and the corresponding distance on the ground. See, map is, we cannot exactly represent the distance of the ground on the map, right? That is why here the scale, it is going to show us the ratio of the distance on the map with respect to what? With respect to the ground. It helps us to know the distance between the two places on the ground. These scales, they are going to help us to make us understand what is the distance between any two places or the distance between the countries. Okay, the distance between two points on the map are closer than the actual distance on the map. Of course, because we have taken the ratio, the distance between any two places in the maps is closer compared to that of the distance between the two places on the grounds. Next comes the latitudes and longitudes. Latitudes and longitudes, they are a grid of imaginary lines, a group of imaginary zigzag imaginary lines, we can say, or a group of lines helps us to find the location, distance and direction of places on the maps. These latitudes and longitudes, they are the imaginary lines which we have drawn. For what purpose? For the purpose of location of distance, purpose of location, then distance and direction of places on the map. Next comes what? Next is direction. Direction. In a map, the direction is shown by the symbol of arrows with the letter N on the top. What happens actually is, on the top of the map, like suppose if we are going to show any map, on the top it is going to, so this is any chart of a map, on the top they are going to show the this direction as north. Depending upon this direction of north, we can identify all the other directions as south, east and west. North on the top, the head of the arrow points the to the north, like this. This is the head of the arrow which is going to point towards the north. Once you know the north, you can easily find the other directions. Next, we are going to know about index or key. Index or key. A symbol used to represent any feature is called index. Any of the symbol might be, for example, we are going to use any symbol for the representation of river, land, church, temple, buildings, school, such type of symbols, they are called as index or key. The index is an important component and represents all the features shown on a map. Index, it is a very important component to represent the features on the map. Various colors and symbols are used in the index. For example, blue color of water body. Suppose this is the map anywhere they have given, they are going to show any like this a blue color. Blue color is shown in the sense it depicts water bodies. Green for lowlands, etc. See here, we can see a map which is having a north direction. So it is showing the direction on the map. Some of the index or key points for political maps are given in your textbook. Just look over once. That is, the first one is international boundary. It has an index or it has a symbol. Then state boundaries, district boundaries are given. Taluk boundaries and their boundary along a river. This depicts what, or this denotes boundary along a river. National capital, state capital, big city, small city or town. These are the symbols used in the maps. We can say that an index or a key. Now let us know about the uses of maps. We studied the uses of globe. Now let us study about the uses of maps. Okay, maps help us in many ways. What are those many ways? Maps help us to locate places like towns, cities, districts, states, countries and continents. Maps help us to locate all these things. They show us the physical features such as what? Such as mountains, plateaus, plains, coastal areas, islands, etc. They help us to know the major routes of transport. Like maps, they also help us to know the routes of transport. That is, might be roads, railways, etc. They help us to understand the distribution of crops and then minerals, industries, etc. Maps are very important for what purpose? For military people at the time of war and at the time of security. Maps guide the tourists for their destination. Those visitors, they have come with the unknown, to the unknown place, right? Those maps help them to go to their destinations. Maps are very good teaching learning aid in the classroom. They are easy to carry. These are how the uses of the maps. Now let us study about the geographical symbols. Geographical symbols. A symbol is a sign that stands for an object. We are going to represent symbols. They to represent any object, right? They are the signs of the object. The symbols used in a map are the same all over the world. A symbol used in one map here is same all over the world. Same symbols represent the same meanings all over the world. The symbols give a lot of information. See, symbols used in topographical maps are given in your textbooks. You can see those symbols, how the church are denoted, temples, Eidgah, mosque, tomb, graves, etc. The symbols are represented like this, and these symbols remain same all over the world. Next comes the colors. After this, we are going to study about, first we studied about symbols, and then now we are going to study about colors on the maps. When you look at a physical map, you can see different colors. Of course, physical map has different colors because it has to represent what? It has to represent water bodies, mountains, plains, rivers, etc. Right? That is why it has different colors. These colors represent different physical features. In a physical map, the colors used are as follows. See, blue color here. We can see the blue color here. It shows what? It shows it is a water body. The same way they have given here. Blue color shows water bodies. Green color shows plains and lowlands. Yellow shows highlands. Brown color shows hill. That is a lower part of mountains. Dark brown color shows high mountains. White color shows snow covered areas. This is how we are going to find colors on the physical map. Besides, different colors are used for political maps to show the different political divisions. Different line symbols with different colors are drawn on a map. Means different line colors are drawn to show what? To show road lines, railways, airways, etc. Black lines are used for boundaries, red for roads, etc. Why do we use black lines? Black lines are used to show the boundaries and red colored lines are used to show the roads. Like that, many more colors are still used. Next comes map reading. Map reading. To read and understand a map, you need to know the meaning of the symbols used, just as you need to know the letter of the alphabet to form meaningful words. See, we to read any alphabet or to read any word, we should know the meaning of the alphabet. That is, A is red like this only, this is A, this is B. This is how we are going to know the meaning of the alphabets, right? The same way to read the map, we should know the meaning of the symbols used in the map. In the same way, you have to know the meaning of colors, lines and symbols which are used on the map. Not only the symbols, but we should also know about the colors, lines and symbols which are used in the map. Map reading is a skill. See, map reading, it is a kind of a skill. We must know the four skills of map reading and we need certain general directions. They are given below. See, to read the map, we need to have the four skills and also some general directions which are given below. Let us see what are those skills. Among that, the first one is to locate places. To locate places. On the map, we have to know what? We have to know the latitude and longitude on which the place is located. To locate any place on the map, we should know where is the latitude and longitude to which the place, where to the latitude and longitude where the place belongs. Next comes to find the direction. What it is? To find the direction. The symbol of the arrow pointing to the north helps us to find other directions. I have said you on the top of the map, we will be having a direction like this, north, which helps us to identify the other directions. Next is to find the distance. To find the distance. The scale given on the map helps us to know the distance between two places. Of course, map is having the scale which is going to help us to know the distance between two places. So, to read a map, what all skills we should have? We should have skills to locate the places, to find the direction and to find the distance. This is all we need to understand or to have read the maps. Okay, so students, in this chapter we studied about globes and maps, uses of globes, uses of maps, and then we also studied how to read a map. I hope you all have followed this lesson. Keep studying and stay safe. Thank you.